everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have an exciting video for you all. It's going to be a Sephora haul. Yay! I'm so happy. I've tried to not use stuff so I wouldn't lose it. So no joke, it's been so long. Like, I would say it's been at least 3 to 4 weeks in my house. Like, I'm going crazy not using it. Like, I've been using it a little bit here and there, but I haven't, like, dove in and used it. What? You know what I'm saying. Anyway, so if you want to see what I recently bought from Sephora, then just keep watching. I don't know where to start, so I'm going to start off with Christmas stuff. I just want to put it out there, I don't buy Christmas stuff unless it's in packs and it does contain permanent items. I don't like buying limited edition stuff, purely for the fact that if I was to run out, I might not be able to buy it again and I would be absolutely devastated. So I just stay clear of, like, limited edition, like, colors and stuff like that. I always buy just value sets kind of things. So the first thing that I picked up was this Too Faced Melted Kisses pack of 4. So they are smaller in size, but the price was relatively cheap for the 4 of them. So it comes with 4 shades. You get Melted Berry, Melted Fuchsia, Melted Peony, and Melted Nude. So just going along there. And I just thought these would be super, super cool to try because they do have these shades in the permanent full size of these, if that makes sense. I'm so frazzled today, I'm so sorry. But yeah, so I just thought I may as well try them, try a few colors for a little bit more than I would pay for one. And if I liked it, then I could buy the full size as well. So far I've used one and I do feel like these are more of a very, very pigmented lip gloss, not so much a lipstick. So yeah, a bit more trial with that, but I can't wait to use this Melted Berry color in the Christmas time. I think that'll be so much fun. So yeah, I'm super, super excited to give these more of a shot. So yeah, excited. So the next thing that I picked up was the Hourglass Arch Brow Sculpting Pencil in the shade Dark Brunette, I think. Yeah, Dark Brunette. So basically, if you haven't seen this before, it's basically just a eyebrow pencil, which you can use to fill in your eyebrows. I think I want to do a review on this. Okay, so the next thing that I picked up is from OCC, and I picked up 3 lip tars. They came in a pack, and they also came with a free brush, which I appreciate because you do need to apply them with a brush. I don't care what anyone says. You need to do it with a brush or a Q-tip or something to get some precision. So the pack came with 3 shades. It's called the Lip Tar Trios in Vivid. 3 shades. First one is Harlot. I think that's how you pronounce it. I love this color. This color is so, so beautiful. I cannot wait to try that out. The shade Troll Pop. I cannot wait to use that. That's going to be amazing for the springtime. And also shade Nylon. I feel like Nylon is going to be the least wearable out of them all. I definitely want to pick up a nude shade just to mix with those lip tars because, yeah, they just seem a little bit too bright. Obviously, I know I bought the Vivids one, but it was just a price factor. It was relatively cheap, so I did want to try 3 for a decent price. And I haven't tried them yet, so I don't know why I'm rambling so much. You guys know that I love bronzer, so I definitely had to pick up at least 1 bronzer. So I decided to pick up the Kat Von D Everlasting Face Shaper Bronzer in the shade Business 2, or Shady Business Number 2. This is what the packaging looks like. It's so, so pretty. It's got little roses embossed into it, like textured matte and gloss packaging. Really, really beautiful. And then this is what the bronzer looks like inside. I've only used it once and I haven't formed an opinion on it yet, but when I do have an opinion, I'll definitely let you know about it. I decided to pick up a duo pack of the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. I like this. I just restrain from using it because it is so expensive, but considering I was able to buy a duo pack for relatively cheap, I'm very, very happy to have it back in my collection, I guess. I picked up 1 Too Faced La Creme Color Drain. I was going to say Color Drained, but it doesn't even say that. It says Color Drenched Lip Cream in the shade Spice Spice Baby. I swear I didn't even put this shade. I didn't order this shade. I swear I ordered that Jelly Bean shade, but looking at it in the tube, I'm actually really, really happy with it. And I think I'm happier with this color. I haven't used it yet, but I can't wait to. So again, with me not liking limited edition sets. I did buy this Christmas pack from Tarte. However, it did come with full size permanent items, so I could justify it because of that. So basically this giant bag full of stuff cost $75 US. I do remember that because it was the most expensive thing I purchased. But it's called the Make and Waves Best Selling Summer Essentials Set. So it comes in a giant makeup bag like this. Love the makeup bag. It's supposed to fold over like that, but either way, it's pretty. And then inside you get the Park Avenue Princess Bronzer, which I already took out of the box. If I can fish it out. It looks like this. And then when you open it up, it is a shimmery bronzer. So if you are looking for a matte bronzer, they do have this in a matte shade as well. But I wanted to try the shimmer because I own a lot of matte bronzers. So I think that's going to be very, very beautiful, especially for the summer months. Obviously, it's a summer kit. Whatever. I just think it's a really, really beautiful bronzer. I haven't used it yet, but I'm very, very excited to. The pack also comes with a lip pencil, which is called the Lips Surgeons Power Pigment Pigment Intense Lip Crayon, I guess, in the shade Exposed. I've never really gotten into the crayons. Like, I own a few, but I'm excited to add this crayon to my collection, to be fair. I haven't used it before. Let's swatch it. Ooh, that's pretty. It's just a nice sheer-ish but not too sheer color. I hope what I said made sense. Like, it's not super opaque, but it's not super sheer. It's just a nice in between. So I am definitely excited to use that. So I also got the Light Camera Splashes mascara. This is a waterproof mascara. I don't want to open it because I don't want it to dry out, but yeah, super happy to add that to my collection. Second to last in the pack is the Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush in the shade Exposed. Now, a girl that I watch on YouTube, her name is Michelle. She is so, so lovely. I'll link her YouTube channel down below. She's literally, like, when I watch her videos, like her haul videos or like her tutorials, I'm just like, you are like my makeup twin that lives on the other side of the world. Like, either, like, her makeup picks, seriously, everything that she's chosen, I either own, is on my wish list, or I've never heard about, but I want. Like, seriously, her makeup choice is just so on point. I'm obsessed with her. And she talks about this blush all the time. She's hit pan on hers. I don't think that I'll ever hit pan because I don't love blush that much. But if someone can hit pan on a blush and she constantly raves about it, like, I've been watching her for a very, very long time, and she's talked about it for a very, very long time, I was like, I need it. So when I saw that it was Exposed in this set, I was like, I need this set. It's such a good deal. And just looking at it in the pan, I can tell that I am going to really, really like it. I don't like bright blushes just because I do have redness. So I've been dealing with red cheeks all my life. So I do like these more dusty, more natural colors on the cheek. Like, if you love bright blushes, all power to you, honey, but just not my jam. Just not my jam. And it just got very, very bright. Oh well. Lastly in the set was this brush, which I really, really think is cute. It matches the makeup bag in the pattern on the handle. Duh. Yeah, I need to wash it before I use it, but it's nice and soft. I like it so far. Probably wouldn't use it for bronzer. I'd probably use it for more foundation, but yeah, I have no idea what this is called, so I'm sorry. So you would have seen in one of my last hauls, I don't know if that's going to be up or this one's going to be up. I think that one's going to be up first. But I picked up a NARS Audacious Lipstick in the shade Anita. I am seriously in love with that. So I decided to pick up two more considering I was buying from the US and they are significantly cheaper over there. Although they do kind of work out to be the same if you include shipping and currency conversion. Anyway, beyond the point, I did want to pick up two. So I didn't want to. I like two shades, so I picked them up. So the first one I'm wearing on my lips at the moment, and that one is in the shade Raquel. Oh, my face is so itchy. This is in the shade Raquel, and it's what I have on my lips right now. It is just so, so beautiful. I don't know if I love it more than Anita, but it is definitely an everyday shade for me, and I'm so glad. Like, these are very, very expensive lipsticks, but I probably like them more than I like MAC lipsticks, and that is saying a lot. I love this and I've definitely used this. I haven't held back. And then the other shade that I got was in the shade Greta. It is a more vibrant color, but it is definitely a color that I wear. If I do go for a bright color, it's either a red or a hot pink like this one that leans a little bit red. I really, really like this shade. It's definitely not as fluoro as how it shows up on camera. I don't know if it's the lighting. Nope, not the lighting. But yeah, this is just a very, very beautiful shade and I'm glad to have added that to my collection. I don't think that I'm going to add many more bright colours. I definitely am going to stick to nudes for a little while, purely because they're so expensive. Okay, so the next thing that I picked up, it's not from Sephora. Don't kill me. It's one thing. Please don't kill me. But this is the EX1 Delete Concealer. I bought mine in the shade D100. And it's basically just a cream concealer, so I'm super excited to try that. I cannot even speak today. But yeah, super excited to try that one out. Maybe I'll love it as more as a foundation, because you all know I love the EX1 Busy Wear foundation. So that has high standards to meet. So all the raves on YouTube made me want to pick this up. This is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in the shade Opal. Now, I already own Moonstone. And I was like, everyone raves about Opal. Why does everyone rave about Opal? I need to pick it up. So I picked it up. This is it here. And I'm going to be 100% honest with you. I've used it once. And no joke, it makes my face look so dirty. So dirty. Like, I don't know if you guys know what I mean by that. But it just makes my skin not look nice. I don't know what was the go. Maybe it was just, it was having a bad day. Maybe I was having a bad day. I don't know. But every time I put Moonstone, which is this one, on my face, I seriously look like I'm glowing. I look illuminated. I just look youthful. It's great. I love this. This one, I've used it once. I need to use it again to give it another shot because it was so expensive. But I'm not digging it as much. Sandstone, Opal. That's a better color indication. But yeah, all power to you if you can make it work. I just haven't been able to make it work yet. But who knows? Maybe in a few months I'll be like, guys, I love it. But at the moment, I don't love it. A few more things, I promise. So I did pick up this limited edition set as well. Sorry if these annoy you, but these are all permanent products, so you can get them individually. This is the Josie Maran Winter Dreams Argan Color Collection. Now, this cost $34. I originally wanted, let me just take it out and show you guys what comes in it. I haven't used this yet at all. I wanted to wait for this haul. So this comes with how many products? Five products? Yeah, five products. So it comes with a 15 mil size of the Argan Oil Light, and then it comes with a 15 mil size of the Argan Illuminator. And then a 5 mil of the cheek creamy oil, lip and cheek creamy oil. Whoops. In the shade Limitless Pink, their mascara, and then also a coconut water eyeshadow in the shade Rio de Rose Gold. Now, I originally just wanted the illuminator because I love glowy skin, but that was already $28. I saw this pack and it was only $34, so another $6 more, and you get a full size of their coconut water eye color thing. So, and I really wanted to try it. It's just that it was so expensive that I didn't really want to like fork out the money for it. So I was like, well, there's two things in this set that I really want. Yes, I know that this is like half the size of the one that I would have bought, but I have so much makeup that I wouldn't finish it all. And if I do finish all, then I'll be happy to go out and buy another one. You know what I'm saying? So I just thought this was such a good deal, such a good value. Can't wait to use this. I want to use this in a tutorial. It just looks so beautiful. I've never used anything like it before, but I cannot wait to use this. It looks stunning in this little compact container. So I'm so happy I bought that. If it's still in stock, I do think it's good value for money if you're wanting to try Josie Maran. But again, I haven't tried it myself, so I don't know if it's actually good or not. But Yegma says that the illuminator is really beautiful, so that alone sold me on it. So, of course, I've got to buy at least one foundation, right? So this foundation is off recommendation from Michelle. She talks about it so much. Again, no joke, I trust her makeup opinions like no other. This is the Lancome Nude Miracle Foundation. This is a new foundation from Lancome. I don't normally get along very well with Lancome foundations, but because Michelle did recommend this one, I definitely did pick it up. And I picked it up in the shade that she has it in, which is the shade 250W. and I think that's called Bisque. Two last products. So this is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. I have it on my face right now. This is it here. I bought mine in the shade 2W2 Rattan. And then sticking with the Estee Lauder theme, I did pick up their Double Wear Concealer as well. I can tell you straight off the bat, I don't like this very much. It's not that good. I would definitely recommend the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer over this. But of course, I'll use it up. And guys, that is all my products. Like, when you're checking out, like, this is more than one shop because I don't like to spend too much money at one go, so I did it more than one time. But, like, you feel like, oh, I've spent so much money, I bought so much stuff. But when I look at how much stuff I have and how much money I paid, I'm like, yeah, I didn't get that much stuff. I don't know. Does anyone else feel like that? I don't know. But anyway, guys, that's all the products I have to show you. Definitely comment down below if you want to see reviews, first impressions, anything like that of anything, and I'll definitely get to it, I promise. And yeah, I hope you're having a wonderful day. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. It helps me out so, so much. And yeah, I will see you next time. Bye.